Hey guys, how's it going and welcome to my new video. So in this video I'm just going to be going over some tips and advice on how to improve your channel on YouTube, so I hope you guys find it helpful and you enjoy the video. So the first thing that I want to go over is being consistent with your uploads as well as your content and timing. Now what I mean by this is you want to make sure that you've got a scheduled upload time as well as similar content each video. Now these are both things that I've failed at pretty badly on my channel over the past however many years I've had it. Now you want to make sure that you're uploading at the same kind of time each week, that way people are going to know when to expect your videos and they're going to know when to look out for them. Now on top of that, you want to make sure that you're uploading similar content in each video, that way people are all subscribing for the same thing. Again, both of those I've failed at on my channel, so it's something I'm trying to fix now. So the next thing that you want to do is make good quality videos. Now this means good video quality, good sound, and you know, good editing. Now if you're in front of the camera and you've got a webcam and you're in a dark room and it's kind of laggy and it's not good audio, people aren't going to watch your videos over and over again unless it's really good. But otherwise, if you've got a good lighting setup, if you've got a nice quality camera and a good microphone, people are going to enjoy your videos that much more and they're going to be that much better. Now if you're behind the camera, you want to make sure that you've got a good microphone and a good screen recorder at least, and then on top of that, try and get yourself a nice intro or just present your videos nicely, and that way people are going to enjoy them, you're going to have a higher chance of people watching your videos. Okay, so after that, when you start noticing that you're building an audience, you're going to notice the same people commenting on each of your videos. Now you want to make sure that you reply to pretty much every comment, but these people in particular, because they're taking their time to comment, and if you don't reply, they're not going to feel like you're reading them, they're not going to feel like you even really cared about it. So make sure that you reply to these comments. It's just going to show that you're actually reading what they're saying and they're going to be encouraged to comment again. Also, this way you're going to kind of start like a bit of an interaction and get a bit of a conversation going with your subscribers, and it's just going to make your channel that much more active. So next thing that you might want to try is networking with other YouTubers. So for example, you can box for box or collaborate. Now with box for boxing, make sure that you are aiming at someone around your subscriber range. Now I don't want to sound like an asshole, but if someone with 100, 200, even 1,000 subscribers messages me and asks me to box for box, unless their content is really good, I'm definitely going to say no. And that's not because I don't want to help them, it's just because I get a lot of messages about people wanting to box for box and I can't really do it for everyone and it's not really going to help me out, so there's not much point in me doing it. So target someone around your subscriber range. If you have 100 subscribers, target someone with, you know, 50 to 300 subscribers. That way you're both going to benefit each other kind of equally. You're going to have your channels grow together. It's going to be that much better for both of you. Okay, so the next thing that you want to try and do is collaborate with other YouTubers. Now again, target someone around your subscriber range. So if you're a commentator, for example, get someone else who does commentaries, who's good, who's got around the same subscribers as you. Ask to do a dual commentary or something like that and do a shout out to each other. Both upload the video. And that way you can kind of swap each other's audiences, get your subscribers subscribe to them, get their subscribers to you. It's just going to benefit both your channels that way. Okay, so the next thing you want to try and do is get shoutouts. Now, if you know how to make intros or YouTube backgrounds, for example, ask people if they want them in exchange for a shoutout. Now, don't go asking someone with 100,000 subscribers because chances are they get hundreds of messages a day and they probably won't see it or acknowledge it and they've already got like a really awesome intro and background. But if you know someone who doesn't really have a good one, who's got quite a big audience, ask them if, you know, you can make them a background in exchange for a shout out. And this is something that really helped my channel out a lot. If you know my channel for a while, I used to make a lot of intros, and one of my friends, iPod Apps Everywhere, kind of made it a rule in one of his giveaways to subscribe to me, and that gave me a heap of subscribers really quickly. And that was a huge help to my channel. So something like that can make a really big difference. Now one of the last things I want to go over is try and get your videos uploaded to a community channel. Now again, this is something that gave me a big boost in subscribers really quickly, and I use the channel Instaman. Now it used to be a lot more popular than it was, but I helped him out a little bit and he uploaded all of my tutorials, speed intros, visual effects and stuff like that, and it got me a lot of subscribers really quickly. Now the last thing I want to go over quickly is do giveaways. Now I don't mean do giveaways to try and get yourself subscribers. Of course, people will come to your videos if it is a giveaway because they can win free stuff, but don't just do it to try and increase your subscriber count. Now do it at things like 1,000 subscribers, 5,000 subscribers, and just reward your subscribers. Now don't just give away something every 2 weeks because you're just going to waste your money and people are only going to subscribe to you for those giveaways, they're not going to watch your other content. So keep that in mind and only do it very frequently when people actually deserve it. So I hope that helped. That is it for this video. If you enjoyed, please give that like button a hit and help my channel out. If you'd like to suggest a topic for next week's video, leave it in the comments or send me a message. And at this point, I'll be going over first cameras and first lenses to buy and stuff like that and just advice on that. Otherwise, be sure to look out for my question video coming this Saturday where I'm answering your guys' questions. And yeah, I hope to see you in the next video, so thanks for watching, and I'll see you later. Goodbye.